We are in the last video of this series. Here we're gonna showcase how all extensions work together. We are gonna upload an invoice document against the purchase order which is created and fully receipted. Let's get into the scenario. I have created a purchase order for a vendor US-104. The purchase order number ends with 525. If we open this purchase order, we see that it is confirmed and it is fully receipted. And I also created a PDF document that is a representation of an invoice of this to import it in Invoice Capture. Now, let's open Invoice Capture app and go to the Receipt File section and upload our PDF document into the Invoice Capture app for recognition. Now, once this is processed through Invoice Capture, this is going to recognize our additional field that we have added in the AI Builder module as well, because we are using that in the processing. Now, Invoice Capture has completed the processing of this document and it is actually having no errors. There are only two warnings. So it is actually awaiting transfer to F&O, because we have the setting that if there are only errors, only then stop it, have a manual intervention. So if we go and look into the document, we will see what it has captured. And here we have the MSME number properly captured from the PDF onto the Dataverse field that we have for MSME code. The invoice is captured and transferred to F&O. If you click on Open D365 button, you will be able to land on Vendor Invoice screen where the invoice is already transferred to. So once you open the invoice, go into the details of the invoice, you'll be able to find that the PDF document that we have used is the one that is referenced here. Now, let's quickly do a match product receipt and then let's actually update the match status. This can actually be done in Process Automation Framework automatically. You don't need to do this manually, but our focus is on the extensibility part, so we are just triggering those actions manually right now. You can observe that the MSME code has been captured fine. And if we go to the header section, the payment terms is set to NET1. So both our extensions are called. So without further delay, let's post the invoice and capture the invoice number so that we can search in the vendor transactions if the MSME code is stamped there. Let's navigate to Accounts Payable, All Vendors, and filter for US-104 and check his the transactions against this invoice. If you go into the record info, you'll be able to see that the MSME code is available. Since we have not enabled it in the UI, you can go use the record info to see all the fields here. The next step is to create a process automation that can pick up these payments for the invoices that are generated. So let's go into system administration and find the process automation. So here we have to create a scheduled process automation of schedule type is vendor payments. Now let's create a series. Let's give it a name and the schedule time to run. Let's set it as a description as priority. Correct the time to run. So let's select a journal name here. And then we will actually go and filter for the records using the MSME code instead of vendor payment method or something. So let's make that change. Let me use the same value that I've used for MSME code from the document here. Now, once we click finish, we'll actually let the payment proposal automation run. So we can actually see the series. There is a schedule created. Now we can go into an occurrence, change its schedule time to run so that it runs faster for us. Otherwise, it will run once in a day only at a particular time. So let's update it to the previous day so that it can run immediately. So once this is run, we'll be able to see a journal, a payment journal generated. And if you go into the view payments, right, the journal number is available here. Once you navigate to the journal, you will be able to see the lines, and in the lines you will be able to see a transaction that is going to settle the invoice that we have. So let's find the transaction. So I believe it's the last one. So let's look at that. Yeah. If you see, this is the invoice that we have actually created earlier. This completes our demo. Let's quickly recap what we have learned over the course of the video content that we have seen. So we have learned how to create a new extension fields on invoice model. We have then learned how to train a custom pre-built model and plug that into Invoice Capture app. And we have then learned how to use this additional information captured in finance and operations to improve and fit it to the business scenario.